When I speak about bells, I have to keep in my mind that it's not just a nostalgia about my own biography, but a nostalgia about the period of extremely high level of cultural life which we had in my expatria, I would say. For a composer, it's necessary to have kind of energy, inner energy from the language, from the roots of the country, of the earth of the country, I don't know how to say it. From my head, it's important to understand this thread going from my Russian period to German, then, and then to French, or just in general, Occidental period of my life. My life was divided into two parts. And of course, now I try to glue these two parts together, but like old cup, which a very good, let's say, porcelain, which you smashed and now try to put all pieces together. When you listen to it, I have a feeling, when I even look at her scores, kind of magnetism, as if she was able to give a kind of magnet, how to say English, magnet, to every note, like to put in energy, even in simple one note. This is a very tricky thing, which just to concentrate your inner energy in one or two notes, do, re, but it's just do, re, but in the context of Усфольская, it's really something more than do, re. I just give this example, but just allegoric example. And she was able to add to this two, three notes kind of really strange energy, sometimes I would say very positive, maybe kind of negative, sometimes I have a feeling, this feeling, but very strong, and in this point I think she is quite unique. It's kind of aggressivity, but not in negative sense, but insisting on her existence, is insisting on her ideas, and this insisting is very, very important in music, I suppose. Just music made of only muscles, without fat, without anything, just muscles.